Hello and welcome to another episode of the channel. Today I want to give you a little orientation when it comes to buying watches at different price levels. If you're entering this hobby or disease, whatever you may call it, the first limitation probably is money. So I can guarantee you that at any price point you're able to get a great watch. Today we're not talking about vintage watches, we're talking about the watches that you can actually buy, or modern type of watches, so current models. Some of them maybe are discontinued, but more or less quite recent iterations. So let's say you have like 100 euros, $100 to spend, you want something robust, and you want something with a heritage to it, then probably go for a G-Shock. In this case, the GA2110 Casio Oak series, because it has some similarities with the Audemars Piguet Royal Oak, this like octagonal shape design, and it's a quartz watch, it's a digital watch, it's a G-Shock, so it's very robust. So for a first watch, let me put it on my 7-inch wrist, it's definitely a great choice, and also something that will get respect by other watch people. So it's something original. Then if you're entering the automatic mechanical watch market, I think there's no way to like pass over the Orient watches. They're so good value for money. In this case, I have the Orient Kano. It's a rather big one. I have featured it on my channel, like all these watches here, and it's just beautiful, and the quality that you get for your money, beautiful turning bezel. Some of you might say, well, it's a copycat of the Tudor Black Bay Burgundy. It is not. It has a modern appeal to it, and who says that Tudor owns the right to put red bezels on their watches? So on my 7-inch wrist, it wears a little bit on the larger side, but I think for the money, under 200 euros, you can get this on a street price. You won't make any mistakes. Then we move ahead and come to the Tissot PRX Precise Robust and 10 atmospheres, so 100 meters of water resistance. It's a quartz watch. You can also get it as an automatic, but basically you're spending 300 euros more to get the same finishing. Of course, then you get the automatic Powermatic 80 movement, but if you already have automatic or mechanical watches in your collection, you simply want the design, you don't want to spend over 300 euros street price, then I think get the quartz one. And it's also quite correct with the history of the PRX in the 70s, or the C-Star. There were also quartz watches, so it's quite accurate from this point. If we move on, I think Seiko is the way to go in the price range sub 1000 euros. And here we have the Seiko Turtle, the King Turtle, how they are called on the market, because they have ceramic bezel inlays, sapphire crystal, they have the 4R36 movement, which is a workhorse, and yeah, you can't go wrong with it. And I think this SRPE 05, the grenade or green version, is the way to go. Sometimes it looks black, sometimes it's more on the green side. It's, I think, a beautiful watch, also with this gold accents. You can see it on the 7-inch wrist. It's quite comfortable because of the small lug-to-lug distance. So I think if you're looking for a nice, decent diver, and you're also looking for specs, if this is important for you, like ceramic, sapphire, probably the Turtle, and you get something really unique with this cushion case design. And a watch that I already called a hidden gem of Seiko's lineup a couple of times is the Sumo. You get a sapphire crystal, aluminum bezel insert. Some people like it more, it's not as shiny as the ceramic. And you get the 6R35 movement with 70 hours of power reserve. If you, for example, have two watches and you put this on, for example, on certain days, and you can leave it a couple of days and it will still run. So probably, especially for someone who's new into watches, I think the power reserve is something interesting to get. If you have more watches, you will see that you don't care about power reserve that much anymore because you set your watches every day. On my 7-inch wrist, it wears quite big because of these really fat lugs, but it has a 20 millimeter bracelet, which makes it look elegant. So I think this is definitely a watch to be aware of. You can get these for around 600 euros street price if you look carefully. So it's a very, very nice diver. And if we're entering the sub 1,500 euro price range, I think you should definitely look for Zinn Spezialuhren watches, and especially the 104. I think it's not a secret. It's featured on several channels like the Urban Gentry channel, and it's praised for a reason. It's just an exceptional good watch, bidirectional bezel, Flieger style, 200 meters of water resistance. You even get a diver's extension. The H-Link bracelet is really solid, and it wears not too big. It's on the smaller side, so it's sporty and elegant. This can easily be your one watch, even with the white dial. It's so versatile. It's great on straps. So I think if you don't want to spend more than 1500 euros, definitely look for the Zinn. And if you're really into Seikos and you want to experience this Serratsu polishing of Grand Seiko, you want something that really stands out and not everyone has, look for the Marine Master 300. It's one of my most beloved watches with this amazing blue dial. It's the SLA 023. It's had a movement that is a base movement that is also used for Grand Seiko models. The bezel action is great, ceramic bezel inlay loomed up to the 20 minute marker, and this thick crystal, this shininess, and it wears actually quite small, even though it's a 44 millimeter watch, because of the small diameter of the dial, it wears or appears to be way smaller than it actually is. And it has this diver extension, which isn't beautiful, but it's on the fly. So I think definitely a watch in the sub 2500 euro price range, street price, if you're able to find it. And last but not least, on the really luxurious, at least for my taste, end, is the Omega Speedmaster Professional. This is the recently discontinued model. I have it on the bracelet, but I put it on this nice Rios vintage racing strap, and it wears just beautifully on the wrist. It's awesome. And probably if you only want to have one piece in your collection, I would go for the Speedmaster. It's a beautiful watch. It has this Moonwatch heritage, which is something really unique. The finishing is really nice. You can wear it on straps, you can wear it on a bracelet, on NATOs. I think this is probably, if I only were able to keep one watch in my collection, it would probably be the Speedmaster. So this is just a few tips on what to probably buy if you want a watch and you have different kind of budgets. I hope this video helped you. Please write in the comments what kind of content do you really want to like to see in the future. Thank you very much for watching, and please subscribe to the channel to help me grow the channel to deliver even better or more content in future. Thanks.